Hello and welcome back to another Cladisms video. In this video, I wanted to try something new in making a long form gameplay video of a build. Now, I thought this would be a lot more interesting than me just doing short little gameplay combat section clips and just showing how a build would play throughout a whole like mission or activity. So the first build I'm going to showcase in this video format is going to be the Collective Obligation on the Warlock. The dim link will be listed in the description if you're interested in copying the build. But let me know if this format is something you guys think is interesting. I am not commentating over the gameplay or anything. I'm just letting the gameplay speak for itself. And it just kind of, it's a fun way to play with builds. There's not much content that you can really test yourself in. And the legendary campaign missions with, you know, the champions and whatnot are a pretty good testing ground for those. So let me know how the first episode of this goes. I'm planning on doing another with the Heart Shadow. But other than that, that is all I have to say in this little intro. So enjoy the gameplay and please leave me some feedback in the comments. Peace.
You took power from this pyramid once before, Guardian. Ikora believes there is more to be found.
How will communing with darkness help us understand the voices we heard when we found Sagira's shell?
Reach the statue at the heart of the pyramid. Strengthen your connection to the darkness, and you will see beyond the limitations of normal sight.
Interesting. I'm picking up a Cabal transmission. I pulled a clip for you.
To the warriors of the Cabal Empire, defectors march upon the European Pyramid, searching for trinkets of darkness. Their expedition is not sanctioned. Any that join them act alone. My father's obsession with the voice in the darkness must not infect our own ranks.
I guess this means the Empress won't mind us fighting our way in. Cabal shield blocking the doorway. Looks like they got up here first. Eris, the pyramid is reacting to our presence somehow. Opening doors, moving platforms.
Perhaps it senses something in you. When I explored these strange passageways, I felt it sensed something in me, too. I resented it at first. To believe it recognized in me some secret kinship. But like you, Guardian, I have learned to use it.
There are Cabal supplies everywhere. It looks like they're trying to establish a foothold inside the pyramid.
Hoping to pilfer artifacts of darkness for their war against war itself, I assume. Zivu Arath destroyed their homeworld, and the conquerors do not take well to being conquered.
I think that device is jamming the pyramid's movement somehow. You said the pyramid recognizes something in us, Eris. But what?
A defender. A finely honed blade. A curiosity. It could be any of those. Or none. My Korra too has asked this question, and my answer is always the same. Pure speculation. I worry the ambiguity weighs on her too heavily.
I don't think the pyramid is helping us out of generosity, Guardian. It's manipulating us, using us somehow. The darkness is a neutral force, but the pyramids have an agenda. Until we know what it is, we can't let our guard down. Something must control these ships, but we've never seen a pilot.
In her journeys beyond the Heliopause, Queen Mara Solve encountered the entity that commands the pyramids. She said its mind spoke louder than any other she has ever heard. A cacophony of thought. Perhaps those voices steer these ships. One of those voices spoke to you in the Black Garden as well.
Ikora said that this new ability allows you to see psychic imprints of past events. And if you commune with the pyramid, you might be able to see the imprint on Sagira's shell. It's strange. The light made you forget, and now the darkness helps you remember. The Cabal are trying to destroy the statue. We have to stop them, or you won't be able to commune with the pyramid.
Thank you.
I can feel it calling to us. Be careful, Guardian. Eris, we communed with the statue. We can't tell yet if anything has changed. It seems like we might not notice the effects until we're back in Savathun's throne world. Either way, we don't want to stay here longer than we have to.